Hey, what's up everyone? Tim here from Everyday Tactical Vids. A couple weeks ago, I put out a video on this right here, which is the Wii Sports Sparrow Egg. And a bunch of people replied and said they've been looking for a very compact backpack or EDC bag that they can carry. So smaller than your average size backpack, just to carry some of the essentials when you're out and about on the town. So today I want to show you another bag. This one's coming to us from Helicon, and I think this might be of interest to you. So today we're looking at this, which is the Helicon Essential Kit Bag. This is actually in their Bushcraft line. You can see the little logo there. But they do have it in a variety of colors, 10 different colors from what I found online over at Military First. And then also, it's a great bag just to throw some of the basics in if you're going out and about on the town. Maybe you're headed to work, but you don't need like your laptop or something like that for the day. So I want to talk about this bag and show you some of the features of it. I'll show you what I have inside it, what it actually carries, and maybe this fits into one of your systems. So with nothing in the bag, you're looking at 11.29 ounces. It's made of 500D Cordura, and this color is called Melange. This is like, it's kind of like some of the colors that Maxpedition has put out in their Entity line. So very subtle, very gray man. Solid straps everywhere, solid buckles everywhere. What we have here is this, this piece of webbing that goes to the top cover, and then two pockets on the side. We do have a fully adjustable strap that's also QD, so you can take that off if you just want to basically throw it into another bag or just throw it in a car. You can see we do have webbing here on the back as well. What I did was I just threw some reflective bands, so if I was out walking at night, I could throw these, you know, on my ankles or on my wrist, whatever, so just a little bit more safety when I'm walking in the evening. When you take the QD section off, you can tuck these down inside here if you want, just to get them completely out of the way. And then you do have a D-ring here if you want to attach something to hang the bag somewhere. Now on the back here, we also have Velcro or hook and loop on the bottom, which is very snug right now. But you can actually run something from the top as a pass-through down to the bottom. So again, if you're using this like in a bushcraft setting, you could run a small hatchet or something like that. Now, a lot of people have already talked about this bag as a bushcraft bag, so that's why I'm talking about it as an everyday carry bag. I just feel like there's plenty of information out there on, you know, how to use it out in the woods, but I do think it could be a really good everyday carry bag for people. Let's take a look inside and see what we've got. So first thing, I've got a water bottle here. So this is a one I got from BattleBox. It's a stainless steel one. You can fit a Nalgene in here, you can fit a canteen in here. If you get a clean canteen that's got one of the taller lids that has the hook you can put your finger in, or you can hang stuff or hang it with, it is a little bit harder to close it. You could still do it, but it's a little bit harder. So obviously I've got a water bottle, which is great, just for everyday carry. I threw in a bandana. This is the Wazoo Survival Gear Wild Edibles bandana, but you know, just to show you could throw in a bandana. We've got the Kevlar spork in here in the main section. I grabbed a hat and some gloves. This is not a huge pair of gloves. They're relatively compact, and you know, a pretty small hat, like a beanie style. But again, you know, you're out and about for the day, things get cold, you've got another extra way to keep your hands and your head warm. And then in this main pocket, there's a drain hole on the bottom, and then there's a back section. And back there, I've got some technology stuff, so cords for charging my iPhone, and some earbuds, and then I've got a anchor battery to charge up gear, and that's basically everything in this main section. Now there is, right here in the front, there's an additional little pocket here, and then down in there, I just tossed a lighter. So I've got a lighter that I can carry with me all the time. So basically that's your, you can just double check to make sure there's nothing there. Yeah, nothing else there. That's your main section here, and this little pocket here. And on the top, you can also see we have a little mesh section, so you can put some gear in up there. One thing to note is that if you put something in here that's very hard, when it closes over, if you've got a water bottle, you know, you gotta push a little bit hard to get the whole thing to compress down. So maybe up on the top, you wanna put something a little bit softer or smaller so you can push it to the side. So when you close it over the top, you can actually close things with your water bottle. All right, looking at this side, open it up, and you can see I've got a tourniquet in here. So this is kind of my med kit side. I've got kind of a boo-boo kit. I've got some throat lozenges. I've got some stuff for allergies. I've got acetaminophen. I got ibuprofen. I got Band-Aids. So just a small med kit, and then obviously a tourniquet for serious bleeding. I've got a emergency blanket, survival blanket, obviously for warmth. Then in the back here, I've got a couple things. This is the Rips Wool from Exotac. So now I got some cordage and some duct tape, and obviously there's a needle inside there. And then the other thing, this is a newer product for me, is the Leatherman Skeletool, and this is in, let me see if I can open this thing up. This is in that coyote brown or that coyote tan, which I think is really cool. So got a multi-tool on me. And again, that's all in this pocket here. And in this pocket, we do have the main section and then another mesh section here. And then we have a little loop so you can attach a carabiner if you want to attach keys or something like that over there. Over on the other side, I've got with me one of those personal alarms. So again, if I'm walking in a place where, you know, I want to grab somebody's attention because I'm injured or something's going down, I got that. This is a tiny little light that's also got a strobe feature on it, so that can attract somebody's attention if I wanted attention. We've got a little notepad to jot down notes. Got some gum in there. And then in here, in the back mesh section, I've got, this is the Benchmade Freak. So I've got a knife with me. This is the, I think this is the Lance. Yeah, this is the Lance from PowerTech. So flashlight, got a pen here. And then I've got a Sharpie as well. Needless to say, if you have to carry like a laptop or other big items like that, this is not the bag for you. But when it comes to a small everyday carry bag that you can just, you know, throw over your shoulder and head out for the day, this might be one you want to check out. Price point for this is around $45, and they do have 10 different colors from like multicam to brown to green to adaptive green. This is, I think, the most kind of subtle color that they have out there as far as kind of a gray man look. That's just because it's gray, but it doesn't look like something that's built for the outdoors or is necessarily built for the military as much. Cool little bag. And if you've been watching my channel, you know, I've been checking out Helicon a lot more in recent days and months, I guess. And I'm liking a lot of their gear. Very creative and different than a lot of the other stuff that I've seen out there. So yeah, I've got links down below. I got this from Military First, so you can head over to their website and pick one of these up. So once again, the color is Melange for this one. It's kind of like a gray with maybe a little hint of blue in it. And this is the Helicon Essentials kit bag. So I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. If you own one of these and you've used it for stuff when it comes to bushcraft, I'd love to hear that. But also if you use it for everyday carry purposes, even, you know, just once in a while, I'd love to hear about that as well. So yeah, let's get the conversation started in the comment section down below. Thanks as always for checking out the videos here on YouTube. Please subscribe to Everyday Tactical Vids if you haven't done so already. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, check us out on Instagram, Tumblr, and Vero as well. More videos coming soon. Take care.